Well, the Arctic is one of those places on the planet where we've kind of thought we would see climate change happening first if it was going to happen. And one of the reasons why we expect places like the Arctic to show signs of warming before we see it in the rest of the world is that the Arctic is covered by snow and ice. And the snow and ice act to help keep the planet cool. So the Arctic is a very sensitive region on the planet that scientists have been really concerned about. If we start to warm up and we start to lose more of a snow and ice, it's going to accelerate the warming that the planet experiences. Well, I think it's sometimes hard to care about things that are so remote from where we live. You know, while there's dramatic changes happening in the Arctic, we don't feel those impacts so strongly yet where we are. But one of the things that we do know is everything is connected.
The atmosphere is being driven by the temperature gradient between the Arctic and the tropics. If I now make the Arctic warmer than it used to be, I've reduced my temperature gradient, and that temperature gradient drives the strength of the winds, and in particular drives the strength of the jet stream. The bigger the temperature gradient, the faster the jet stream. So what we know will happen, and what we have observational evidence to suggest has already happened, is that the jet stream is slowing down. The reason that this project is timely and that we're doing it now and that we were able to get funding to do this now, so one is that the loss of sea ice in the Arctic has accelerated in the last several years. You know, we keep setting new record minima for end of summer sea ice extent, and so that has really drawn the attention both of climate scientists but also of the public. I think the other part of this is that as climate scientists, we've started to get the hints of how the sea ice is impacting mid-latitude weather. We've seen some casual relationships that we suspect have a good physical grounding, that, you know, years when we have less sea ice in the Arctic, we've seen really pronounced cold outbreaks in Asia, in Eastern Asia. We've seen them in Eastern North America. We've seen them in Europe. You know, we've had a lot of very cold winters in the last several years, you know, across all three of these Northern Hemisphere continents. You know, we see these connections, but we haven't had the time to be very quantitative and tease out and say, yes, this is being driven by the changes we see in the Arctic, as opposed to this is just a coincidence. And so I think, you know, as scientists, we want to know that. The ultimate goal of the project is really to understand what drives the weather that we experience in the United States, and in particular winter weather. Gaining a better understanding of what is controlling that, allowing us to maybe make seasonal predictions to say, you know, the sea ice was really low this year, we should expect to have a very stormy winter, allows cities and states to better prepare, to have more salt on hand, to, you know, adjust their budgets to deal with the fact that they have to clear all this snow. It helps airlines plan for, you know, potentially more difficult winter seasons of traveling, lots of canceled flights. So I think the societal impacts of this are tremendous, right? The weather drives everything that we do in the end.